Hey guys, Davey here from Davey and Krista, and today I want to chat a little bit about search appearance and the importance of search appearance because I think it's a topic that's sort of overlooked. Something I see in Facebook groups that I'm a part of where people are sharing announcements that they just launched a new site, and then they share their website in Facebook, and what it says is something like home. And then it has a really generic description under that. And obviously they're sharing the homepage of their site. But that's not how you want your website to appear on Facebook to people. And that's not how you want your website to appear in a Google search result, right? You want to be as descriptive as possible because the more legitimate your result looks in Google, the more descriptive it is, the more it looks like it might answer somebody's question, the more likely somebody is to click on it. And so this tutorial specifically is going to be for Showit. I've done another one for WordPress that you can check out as well. So let's dive in and talk about how you would affect the search appearance of your own website. So if I'm in my Showit app here, and this should look familiar to anybody who has Showit, what I probably have over here are, you know, my pages. And what probably happened when you were developing those pages, when your designer was developing those pages, they probably gave them pretty generic names, right? And so this is the homepage, and it just makes it easy for us to access it when we need to make changes to the homepage. But that's not search engine friendly. It's not visitor friendly. It doesn't tell people what's on the homepage. But this is what's used by default if you don't set something in place of it. So you can see this is the page info, this is the page name, and this is the page slug. We're not gonna mess with that because if we change that, it's going to change the URL of the page, and we don't wanna do that. What we wanna do is we wanna come down here to SEO settings. And in SEO settings, we can change the page title and we can change the description. And so what we're changing here, the page title, and this is the SEO description or meta description, all right? And what we want to do is we want to give it a descriptive page name. And we want to accurately describe what's on that page. And so this is the homepage of our wedding photography website. And we are Annapolis, Maryland wedding photographers. And so that's what we've put here. And what we always do, we always follow this format when we're naming pages, is we put our brand name, our business name at the end of that. So we have for our homepage here, Annapolis, Maryland wedding photography or photographers, followed by a separator, and then Krista A. Jones Photography. And then in the meta description, we've tried to further elaborate on that and make it as appealing as possible to click on. You know, if you can include a call to action there, that's great too. And then in show it here, you could even add a share image. And the share image is just the image that would appear if this page was shared on a platform like Facebook. And so if you can affect those things, in my opinion, you definitely should. So come in here and all you have to do, you can do this for every single page, all right? So just click on the page, come down here to SEO settings, and you can change how your page would be displayed when it's shared on Facebook or when it's shared on Google. The one thing that I'm going to mention, and I go into this in further detail in another video specifically on the Showit SEO settings, is meta keywords. These aren't used anymore. In my opinion, Showit should just get rid of that box altogether. I don't think there's anybody out there who believes they help you, and they have the potential to hurt you if you use, you know, certainly I would think if you use too many of them. So just ignore that box, but definitely fill in page title, meta description, include a share image, and then for the page title, we like this format, having the title of the page followed by the brand or business name. And whenever you hover over a tab in Google, you can kind of see, okay, you can see that's the title of the page, Annapolis, Maryland Wedding Photographers, Krista A. Jones Photography. So that's it for today.